Alright, what is up? Today I got this video. This is like a composition slash painting or something, and we are going to create this with stock images and brushes, and everything is free and in the description down below. So if you want to create something like this, just watch the whole video and you will learn everything I know about this. So let's just get into it. Right, now I'm gonna go for white screen here, so I have some more space. So start off with new file, and let's start with these mountains. I want all these mountains for my background, so I'm just gonna select the quick selection tool and select this sky. Don't worry about this, we will fix that in a minute. So make this selection of the sky, and now to bring it back, just select this one and just select these pieces again, like here, these. Doesn't have to be really precise because it's just the background, you won't see it much, so I'm gonna do it like this and select this whole thing. Now make a mask, select the mask fit and press Ctrl I to invert it, and right mouse click, apply layer mask, and select it all. So Ctrl A, Ctrl C to copy it, and let's put this in our file. Press right mouse and convert smart object and resize this so we can stretch it out as this whole background. Now I want to get rid of all these trees here and stuff, so I'm just gonna create a mask. Select the gradient tool, press D on your keyboard to make sure you have white to black, and while holding down shift, just make this line. Just the other way around, like that. So you can just press a couple of times until you get it right. So I think this is fine for now, and let's go on to the next photo, our clouds. So I'm just copy this and paste it in our file. Convert to smart object and resize this. See, and let's do the same here. Gradient, mask, and make this little line. Can make this bigger. And bring this down so we have some space here left for the sky. Can always just brush parts like that, especially this part. Right, I'm gonna leave it like this for now and adjust it later on if it doesn't look right. All right, now let's import our sky. Let's see, we don't need that. So I'm just copy this and put it behind all the layers. Make smart object again and resize this. Want to make sure they have this sunset in the center of this image, so we can create some nice lighting there. Okay, I think this looks okay for now. And let's import our castle. Copy this again and put it above all the other layers. Make a smart object, and I think it needs to be somewhere here. Now I want to make a mask again of it. Select a general brush, normal brush. Select the black color and just brush these parts away from the bottom, so these clouds will just like go around it. Maybe that's just a little bit too much, so if it's too much, just select the other and bring some back. I think this is fine, maybe a little bit smaller. Like that. Now I want to adjust this color, so let's put this in folders. This is our Kestrel. Clouds. Mountains. And sky. Alright, now this Kestrel needs to be a little bit like brighter, something like that. And let's adjust the color. So I'm gonna remove some color from it so it blends in better. Gonna drop down the saturation here like that. You can even make it a little bit transparent, like it's so far away and not so close to the camera. Maybe that's too much, a little bit. Right, I want to use this cliff for the foreground, so I want to get rid of that blue. So I'm just going to go to channels, select this blue, duplicate this channel, and select the quick selection tool, and make this selection. Alright, that is fine, and delete this channel again and make a mask. I can fix these parts. Like this. Alright, now let's apply layer mask. Drag it in our file. And let's put this on top of all the other layers, convert smart object. And let's see, can create like a mountain on this side. So we have some more depth in this image. Okay, I think this was fine. Gonna leave it like that for now. You can always change it later on. So that's our sunlight, and let's also edit these clouds a little bit. So I'm gonna create a new saturation. It's like this, and see, a little bit less color. Like that. Also need to edit this Kestrel a little bit. All right, now this can be even brighter like that. I'm trying to create some more contrast. All right, now let's edit the sky. So sky layer, use saturation, and drop the color from it. Like that, and some curves. So we can get this background really light. Not too much, but just lighter than that. And also edit this mountain here. Let's put this in a folder. mountain front. So hue situation, drop the color and some curves. To make it darker. And these parts lighter. All right, that is fine for now. Maybe a little bit more yellow from the sunset, a little bit more red. All right, now I want to create some water here so we can create a reflection of this castle in the water. So just gonna select this castle folder and the clouds folder. Hold down shift, select them both, duplicate it, and press Ctrl E to rasterize this. So we have these both files in one now, and let's delete this part. So I'm just gonna select this, press delete, so we only have this left, and let's transform this and flip vertical. Now move it down. So gonna have like this water here, and let's create some reflections from the water. So just gonna go to distort, displace, 1020 is okay, and press okay. And now I wanna select this PSD file. I will link this in the description so you can download this and use it, and press open. So now we have this water reflection here. And I'm gonna drop the opacity a little bit here, so like that. Can even move this up, make a mask, and do it a little bit like that. All right, now I wanna create some depth in this image, so I'm gonna use this and place it like here. Doesn't matter if the quality is bad because I'm gonna blur it out anyway. So let's see, maybe turn this around, get rid of this part here, and let's make a smart object here so we can always adjust the blurriness. Go to blur, Gaussian blur, and blur this out. So we have our focus on this castle here. Okay, I think this looks fine. We can even try to duplicate it and put another one on this side. Like that. I'm not sure about this mountain. Can maybe even get rid of that one. It's a little bit too dark. I'm just gonna leave it for now and maybe delete it later. Let's add some details to this. So I'm just gonna add these birds. Let's make a new folder for this. Copy it, paste it in the file, convert to smart object, and let's see, maybe some there, and let's take another one, this one, smart object, maybe some coming from this. Kestel. Maybe the other side, flip it around. Like that. Can even make these bigger so we can see them better. Okay, I think this is fine for now. Okay, now I wanna create something here, like someone is standing here and watching down. So I found this image that I'm going to use and just copy this and put it above all the other layers. And let's make a smart object here. Resize this. Maybe something like this. I think we need to make this bird smaller. And let's blur this out. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Because we have a focus on this Kestel here, so I want to blur this person out. So we have some nice depth in this image. Something like that. And let's do some curves here, because he's too dark now. Something like that. And let's also make another curves layer. And and also make some areas darker. So I'm just gonna create a new curves layer for the darker areas and remove it on these parts, because we have the light coming from there, so these are probably lighter. Maybe this is a little bit too light, so I'm just adjusting that. And we need to get rid of that color, so I'm just going to create a new situation here and drop this color. Maybe you can make this smaller so you can see his head. Like that. Now we have to adjust these parts again. And probably get rid of this here. Like that. Right now, I don't like this mountain here anymore, so I think I'm just gonna disable this because it's way too much stuff going on here on the foreground, so I still wanna keep the focus on this. And I can move this a little bit to the right, like that, and see, believe it's like this. All right, now I want to add some bokeh flare here, so I'm just gonna use this image and let's convert this to smart object and change blend mode to screen and have like this little flare there going on. So let's make a mask, select this part only, select inverse, press D on your keyboard and press Ctrl backspace to remove the rest. So if this nice light coming from there. All right, I'm gonna do some final adjustments here. So I think the sky is a little bit too dark. So let's create, select the sky layer on top of all those adjustment layers and go to brightness contrast and increase the brightness here. So this was before and this after. It's a little bit lighter now. And let's do some color balance here. So on top of all the layers, it's gonna add a little bit more blue. Like that. And let's do some curves. Okay, now this piece is a little bit too light, so I'm just gonna select this layer and create a new curves layer on top of it. Select this and bring the midtones down. So it's a little bit the same like his back because we have light here and not really on this side. So make it darker like that and you can always make these parts lighter again because we have sun coming here. So it looks more real. So this is before and this is after. It's a little bit better now. Okay, now I still have this mountain here that I disabled, so I still want to use it somewhere. So I'm just gonna see what we can do with this. Maybe if we put it like that. And add a little bit of more blur to it. So not as much as this, but a little bit less blur because it's not so close to the camera. So I'm just gonna go to blur, Gaussian blur, and make sure it's between this and this. So this is way too much and we need to make it like something like this. Little bit less blur, but still blurred out. I think I need some little bit more blue now, like that. Now let's edit these mountains a little bit because we didn't edit them at all. So they are a little bit too bright now. So I'm just gonna select this mountains layer. Create a curves layer on top of it, select this, and bring down the midtones and the highlights. So they are a little bit darker now, and select the mask of it, and make some areas lighter again, like the top parts. Just make sure the brush isn't too big. This is way too big. Some more light here and make these top areas lighter. maybe also some of these, like these top areas from these mountains. There was a little bit too much, so I'm just gonna bring it back. Something like that. And let's edit the curve or the color. Let's see. Like that. Now let's fill up this space here. I'm gonna select this mountain, duplicate it, and move it to that side. Flip it horizontal. And let's see. Just have an extra little mountain here. Like that. Okay, now I'm gonna edit this guy here. I think he's a little bit too much blurred out, so select the Gaussian blur layer, double click on it, and just drop this a little bit so you can see him better. I think this is better. And these birds here, they are a little bit too big, so I'm just gonna make them smaller again. So yeah, I think this is it for this one. I can go on forever with adding stuff and editing, but the video will be too long. So anyways, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like this video if you like this kind of stuff, and don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next video.